Wow, doesn't that water get you in the mood for summer? I am so excited for summer. I love beach decor. I'm going to be using all Dollar Tree products. I hope you enjoy this video. These are really cute. They come out adorable. So I'm going to take the liner, trace it, cut it out. Next, I'm going to be taking this cameo pink and jack-o-latern orange color and combine them together because I want to make like that coral looking color. To apply the paint, I'm going to be using a makeup sponge. Liner has a lot of different little tiny holes. I'm just going to dab the paint going up and down motion. Next, I'm going to be taking the poster board that I got from Dollar Tree. I'm going to trace the liner and I'm going to use that as a backing. I didn't do anything to the fish. I thought it was adorable the way it was, and I think it's perfect for this picture that I'm going for. All right, so now I'm going to take some hot glue and place the liner down on the backing. Now I'm going to hot glue down the fish on top of the liner and put the frame on top. Because the fish was quite bulky, it was very difficult to put the frame on, so I do change it at the end and I put the fish and hot glue it to the top of the glass. Now I'm putting everything back together. And this is how it came out. For the next one, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take this Caribbean blue and mix it with some white and dab on the paint on the liner. Do the same process. I'm going to cut it, put it inside, and I'll show you everything at the end, how they all came out. I think they came out very pretty. I did add a Dollar Tree seahorse and added it with the color territorial beige, added a touch of blue on the edges, and this is how it came out after I glued everything to the top. Okay, for this DIY, I took Dollar Tree, the beach sign, and the Dollar Tree napkins. I'm going to be using this paint to paint half the beach sign. I'm not sure the name. I will link it in the description box. I know the name is faded. Okay, so what I'm going to do is take my ruler, and I'm just going to take my pencil and go across the beach sign because half is going to be painted, half is going to be Mod Podge with the napkins. So I'm going to start painting just the half, top half of the beach sign with this color. Now I'm going to be taking these napkins from Dollar Tree. And I'm just going to place some Mod Podge down on the beach sign and then place the napkin right over the top. Next, I'm going to be taking the Mod Podge and apply it over the top of the napkin. I think these napkins are very pretty from Dollar Tree, very beachy. I decided to do the split because I didn't want to just paint it one color. It's kind of boring, so I thought this would be a great idea. There's a lot of napkin here, so I need to start cutting down the pieces so I can get closer to the beach sign. And then once I get close enough, I'll use a file or sandpaper actually and start cleaning the edges. So I'm using a Dollar Tree piece of sandpaper and I just wrapped it around a ruler, which makes it easier for me to, it's a more solid piece to actually, instead of a little piece of sandpaper. So because there's a crease in the middle, I want to blend the napkin and the paint together. So I'm just going to take the paint and just go over the napkin to make it look like it was one piece. I added two little starfish to the sign off camera. I love the two-tone. I think it came out really pretty. It's perfect for the beach kind of theme or coastal, and this is how it came out. For this one, you're going to be using Dollar Tree products, Dollar Tree wood arrow, and the Dollar Tree decorative rocks. So first thing I'm going to do is remove the string, and then I'm going to start painting it with this Caribbean blue paint. I'm just going to be applying one quick coat, and I think the color with the white rocks, the combination looks so pretty, so beachy. So these are the white rocks I'm going to be using. These were bought from Dollar Tree. They have all kinds of rocks there, all colors. And so what I'm going to do is take a bunch of rocks out, lay it on the wood arrow, and spell the word beach. So now I have the rocks positioned where I want them. I'm going to start hot gluing them down. It's a little time consuming. That's why I laid the rocks down off camera. But you get the idea. It's very simple to do and it's very cute. All right, so the rocks are all finished. I'm going to take this jute twine that I got from Dollar Tree. I'm just going to wrap it around the end of the arrow four times. I also added a little starfish sticker and jute twine hanger off camera. And this is how it came out. I think it came out very cute. Alright, for this DIY, I'm going to be using Dollar Tree products again, the Dollar Tree Wood Mermaid, Dollar Tree little sign, and I'm not going to be using that. I'm going to replace it with a Dollar Tree ribbon. I'm going to use the Dollar Tree blue rocks and the shells. I'm going to start off by using the white Waverly chalk paint, and I'm just going to paint the mermaid in this color on the top half of the body. So I'm trying to remove the star that's on her hand because I need to paint around her arm and hand. So I just took it off and then I will replace it. Now I'm going to be using navy blue to paint the mermaid's tail. So I'm going to be using these Dollar Tree little shells for her hair. I'm just going to place it down and pick the smallest ones I can find. I'm going to place it down. Well, I tried it with the Mod Podge. It didn't work. Then I tried it with the Elmer's glue. It didn't work. So I had to use some hot glue and some Elmer's glue. See, I'm trying with the Elmer's glue And it's not working. You know, this is the part of crafting, trial and error. I'm giving up on the little shells right now. I'm moving on to the mermaid's body, and I'm going to be using the Elmer's glue again, and that doesn't work. I was just having fun doing this, believe me. I thought it was automatically going to stick, and it didn't. So, yeah. I had to put loads and loads of Elmer glue all over it, like pile it on for it to stick. Alright, so I'm giving it a try again, but I do successfully get it to work, and I had to put a lot of glue as well. Alright, so this is what it looks like once it's finished. Now I'm going to take this Caribbean blue, because I'm going to cover the stones with this color to make it like a two-tone color, because it's just too dark of a blue, and plus the wood in between is showing, so I'm getting in between, so this, therefore you can't see the wood, and it's giving it a two-tone look on the rocks. Now I'm going to be taking the tag from Dollar Tree. I'm going to use the other side of it, and I'm going to start adding a bunch of different colors. I'm going to start with the Caribbean blue and a little bit of white. Sorry, it's out of frame. So I'm going to start off with the Caribbean blue. It's at the bottom. I'm adding a little bit of white. You'll see as I go, the camera moves up a little bit. Now I'm moving on to the next color. Basically what I'm doing is it's going to look like the ocean, like light color of blue, darker color of green, and then the darker color of blue. So that's the concept I was going for, and you'll see it at the end. It really comes out nice. Now I'm adding the navy blue with a little bit of white. This is going to be like the darker part of the ocean. Now I'm going to be using a baby wipe, and this is going to give it that really great effect. I'm just going to wipe it down side to side, and you'll see the effects. It looks really cool. So I'm going to be using this mesh ribbon that I got from Dollar Tree. I'm just going to put one strip in the back. To hold it down in place, I'm just going to apply a very tiny bit of hot glue, because I'm going to be applying the mermaid over the top, so that should hold it in place pretty well. Now I'm just going to trim off the excess ribbon, and then I'm going to place the mermaid right on top with some hot glue. Love the way this came out. So vibrant, so full of color. And this is what it looks like. Okay, this one is going to be the three wood palettes from Dollar Tree. I'm going to take the Waverly white chalk paint and some of the elephant gray, and I'm going to start painting with the white Waverly chalk paint. I'm just going to paint it with one coat. I'm going to be using agave paint by Waverly chalk paint, and I'm just going to paint the middle part of the wood palette. I'm going to be using this wood bead garland that I got from Dollar Tree, and it has like three little anchors on it, and I'm just going to paint those three with the agave paint. I'm going to leave the other part of the beads natural color. Now I'm going to take the white Waverly chalk paint, and I'm just going to like distress the part where the agave is. Now I'm going to be using the elephant gray, and I'm going to apply that on the white part of the wood palettes the same way. Alright, so I'm going to be using this white yarn, or actually string, and I grabbed a bunch of these from Dollar Tree. They come in a pack. I went ahead and already painted it with the elephant gray and highlighted it with a little bit of the white chalk paint. Now I'm just placing a little glue in the back, and I'm going to wrap it around twice and then hot glue it. I'm just going to do the one and the rest off camera. So I'm going to grab one of the palettes and I'm going to place it in front with some hot glue. So I want to stack the palettes, so I'm just stacking them on top of each other and getting them situated the way I like it. And then I'm going to start adding some embellishments around it. And I think this is coming out so cool for a coastal theme. Now I'm going to take the Dollar Tree wood beads and this ribbon, and I'm going to place the ribbon on top and get it situated the way I like it. And then I'm going to place the wood beads on top and let it like kind of flow all the way down, and you'll see what it looks like. I think this came out so adorable. I think between the ribbon and the wood beads makes it so coastal looking, so beachy. And I do add some white cotton nautical rope from Dollar Tree, and I do cut it and then place it inside, and that really tops it off. You'll see how everything comes together at the end. I think this is my favorite DIY by far today. So here you can see I'm placing down the nautical rope, and I'm trying to get it positioned the way I like it. And there it is. I mean, this came out amazing. I love it. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. I really would appreciate it. Until next time, guys, I will see you. Bye-bye.